Hello students, hope you all are fine. In the previous classes we discussed about how to solve the quadratic equations. Now onwards we'll check how to solve the word problems there. So many word problems are there. So in some questions only I'll solve for you. Rest you can solve by yourself. You can use your convenient method there. And writing all the questions here will be difficult. That's why already I send the questions to you through WhatsApp. I hope you all have checked the questions there. Once again, I will read the questions only. I will not write the questions here. It will take a lot of time there. So moving on to the first question. The first question is, sum of the squares of two consecutive natural numbers. Consecutive natural numbers. They are natural numbers and they are consecutive, means one by one. The numbers are like 2 and 3. Next pair, 3 and 4. So in this way we have to take the numbers there. So we'll take the numbers as x and x plus 1. So we'll write there, let the numbers be x and x plus 1. Now it was written sum of the squares of two consecutive natural numbers. Sum of their square. So we have to do the squares of these two numbers and we have to add. So it will be equal to x square plus x plus 1 the whole square is equal to, it was written there, 313. We'll simplify it using identity. So it will be equal to x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 313. So we are getting a quadratic equation. We'll shift all the numbers to one side. So it will be equal to 2x square plus 2x, 1 minus 313 will be equal to minus 312 is equal to 0. As we can check, all the numbers are divisible by 2. So we can divide it by 2 to make our calculations easy. So x square plus x minus 2 ones are 2, 2 fives are, then 2 6 is equal to 0. Afterwards, you can solve the quadratic equation by your own method there. So once I will show you how to solve the equation. If you are solving it by quadratic formula, here we have a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1 and c is equal to minus 156. I hope all have understood the quadratic formula method there. B square minus 4ac by 2a. We are going to substitute the values. X is equal to minus b. So it will be equal to minus 1 plus or minus square root of b square. 1 minus 4 into 1 into minus 156 by 2a. Minus 1 plus or minus square root of 1. Minus into minus will be equal to plus. 4 6 are 24, carry over 2. 4 5 are 20 plus 2, 22, carry over 2. 4 1s are 4 plus 2, 6 by 2. So minus 1 plus or minus square root of 625 by 2. And we know square root of 625 is 25 by 2. So first we can take the positive and negative sign afterwards. So x will be equal to minus 1 plus 25 by 2. Or next value minus 1 minus 25 by 2. 25 minus 1, 24 by 2 will be equal to 12. Minus 1 minus 25 will be equal to minus 26. Divided by 2 is equal to minus 13. In the question it was written natural number, but in quadratic equation we must have two equations. Whether we will take the negative numbers or not, you have to write down two values there. Now since in the question it was written the numbers are natural number, so we will neglect this one. So therefore our value of x will be equal to 12 and next number is x plus 1. So that will be equal to 12 plus 1 is equal to 13. In word problems always answer statement should be written. So at last write down the answer statement. The numbers are 12 and 13. I hope all knows now how to solve the quadratic equation. So from the next question onwards, I'll write the equation. You can solve the quadratic equation. So moving on to the second question, it was written, the sum of two numbers is 48. So first sentence is sum of two numbers. So we'll take the two numbers as x and y. Let the two numbers be x and y, and it was given their sum. So x plus y is equal to 48, and it was written their product is 432. So if you will check, next one will be equal to x into y is equal to 432. So from the first equation or second equation, we can convert these two in terms of quadratic equation there. So if from the first equation, y can be written as, I am shifting x to right hand side. So it will be equal to 48 minus x. Not necessary that we can shift from the first equation only. If you want, you can write from here also. From here, y will be equal to 432 by x. So from the first equation, substituted, taken the value, and I will substitute the value in the second equation. In place of y, we are going to write 48 minus x is equal to 432. Now we'll simplify it. X into 48 will be equal to 48x, x into minus x square is equal to 432. We are getting a quadratic equation, so we can shift all the expressions to one side. It will be equal to x square minus 48x plus 432 is equal to 0. So we got the quadratic equation. Now you can solve the equation by your own method. Start solving. I hope all have solved the question there. If not solved, you can check. I am writing the answer here. The two numbers will be equal to 36 and 12. If you haven't completed it, you can complete it afterwards and you can check the answer there. We'll get the two numbers as 36 and 12. The next question is, third one it was written, find two consecutive odd positive integers. Now here it was written odd positive integers. So we can check the format of odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7 in this way. So 1, and for getting the next odd number, we have to add it by 2. So 1 plus 2 will be equal to 3. To get the next one, we'll do plus 2 there. So if I am taking the first odd number as x, then second odd number, how we will write? X plus 2. So the two odd numbers will be equal to x and x plus 2. So we'll write right here, let the two odd numbers be, let the two odd numbers be x and x plus 2. Now in the question it was given, find two consecutive odd positive integers, sum of whose squares. We have to do the square of these numbers and their sum. So it will be equal to x square plus x plus 2 the whole square is equal to 290. Again we'll simplify it. X square plus 4x plus 4, 290. I'm shifting to left hand side. Minus 290 is equal to 0. X square plus x square will be equal to 2x square plus 4x, 4 minus 290. So 90 minus 4 is 86. So it will be equal to 286 is equal to 0. All the numbers are divisible by 2. So we can divide it by 2. X square plus 2x minus 143 is equal to 0. Now start solving the equations. So you can check the answers here. The numbers are 11 and 13. If not completed, you can complete it afterwards and you can check the answer there. The two numbers will be equal to 11 and 13. Now moving on to the next question. As you know, the next question is find two consecutive natural numbers whose product is 240. We want two consecutive natural numbers. So let the numbers be two consecutive numbers. So first one is x and second one will be equal to x plus 1. Now it was given their product is 240. So it will be equal to x into x plus 1 is equal to 240. We will simplify it. So it will be equal to x square plus x, 240 I am shifting to left hand side, minus 240 is equal to 0. So we got the equation. Now all can solve the equation. So you can check the answer to this question will be equal to 15 and 16. Answer will be equal to 15 and 16. Always write down the answer statement there. Next question. The sum of a number and its reciprocal is 2, 1 by 30. Sum of a number and its reciprocal, like in this way. If the number is 2, then its reciprocal will be equal to 1 by 2 and their sum is given. So in place of 2, I am going to write down the variable there. The sum of a number and its reciprocal. So let the number be x. So sum of the number, that is x plus its reciprocal, 1 by x is equal to 2, 1 by 30. In the question it was given. Now we'll simplify it. We'll do the cross multiplication. So it will be equal to x into x, x square plus 1 by x is equal to, here also we'll convert it into improper fraction, 30 into 2, 60 plus 1, 61 by 30. Again, cross multiplication, shifting the numbers to their respective sides there. So it will be equal to 30x square plus 30 is equal to 61x. We'll shift all the numbers to one side. 30x square minus 61x plus 30 is equal to 0. Such a big number. So using quadratic formula will be easy for us. So writing the quadratic formula, x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Now we'll substitute the values. All can do with me there. X is equal to minus b. So it will be equal to minus of minus 61 plus or minus square root of b square. Minus 61 the whole square minus 4 into 30 into 30 by 2a, 2 into 30. Minus into minus will be equal to plus 61 plus or minus square root of, you can check what will be 61 square. So 61 square is 3721 minus 4 threes are 12, 12 threes are 36, and then these two zeros we will write there by 2 into 30 will be equal to 60. Just to do the subtraction there, so it will be equal to 61 plus or minus square root of 121 by 60. And square root of 121 is 11. So x is equal to 61 plus or minus 11 by 60. So we'll get two values of x as, first is x is equal to 61 plus 11 by 60 or 61 minus 11 by 60. 61 plus 11 will be equal to 72 by 60 and 61 minus 11 will be equal to 50 by 60. So both the numbers are divisible by 12, so we can cancel it by 12. 12 6 are, 12 5s are, here zeros will get cancelled. So we are getting the two numbers as 6 by 5 and 5 by 6. Both are correct, because if you will take the number as 6 by 5, its reciprocal will be equal to 5 by 6. Or if you will take the number as 5 by 6, its reciprocal will be equal to 6 by 5. So we will write the answer statement as the number is 5 by 6 or 6 by 5. So moving on to the next question. Next question is, the sum of two numbers is 18. So we read the first statement there, just write down there. We want two numbers. So let the two numbers be x and y. Let the two numbers be x and y. Now it was written their sum is 18. So it will be equal to x plus y is equal to 18. So from here either y or x we can convert there. So normally we are writing in terms of x. So I am writing y is equal to 18 minus x from this equation there. Now the second one, it was written the sum of their reciprocals is 1 by 4. Sum of the reciprocal of both. So reciprocal of x, 1 by x. Reciprocal of y will be equal to 1 by y. Is equal to, it was given sum of their reciprocal is 1 by 4. In place of y, we can substitute 18 minus x is equal to 1 by 4. Now again, cross multiplication. So it will be equal to 18 minus x plus x by, x will be multiplied by 18 minus x. So it will be equal to 18x minus x square is equal to 1 by 4. Here minus x and plus x will get cancelled. So we'll get there 18 by 18x minus x square is equal to 1 by 4. Again cross multiplication there. So it will be equal to 72 is equal to 18x minus x square. Shifting all the expression to one side. X square minus 18x plus 72 is equal to 0. Now you can solve it by your own method. I hope you all have solved this, and answer to this question is 12 and 6. The two numbers will be equal to 12 and 6. Here I think when you will solve, you will get these two values only. So if one number is, sum of two numbers is 18 written there. So if x is equal to 12, then y will be equal to 6. Or if you will take x is equal to 6, then y will be equal to 12. So both the answers are correct. You will write the numbers are 12 and 6. Next question. It was written the difference of two numbers is 4. So again, let the two numbers be x and y. You can write there, let the two numbers be x and y, and it was written their difference is 4. So x minus y is equal to 4. So whenever we are doing any question related to difference there, we have to check the greater number. So since I wrote x here first, the number x is greater. That's why we are getting the answer positive here. Otherwise, if x is smaller, suppose I am taking x as 3 and y as 5. Then 3 minus 5 will be equal to minus 2. But here we are getting a positive number. Therefore, we will conclude here x is greater than y. The next sentence is written there. If the difference of their reciprocals is 4/21. This one I'll explain you with the example there. At present we said here x is greater than y. Then what we can say about their reciprocal? 1/x and 1/y, which one will be greater? 1/x will be smaller than 1/y. Why I am saying? Just to take the example there. The number 3 is greater than 2. Correct? But when I will take the reciprocal, it will be equal to 1/3, and here it will be equal to 1/2. So when we will take the reciprocal, we will get the opposite there. 1/3 is smaller than 1/2. So in the same way, if x is greater than y, then reciprocal of x will be smaller than the reciprocal of y. So it was written there, if the difference of their reciprocals. So we'll write 1/y minus 1/x is equal to 4/21. So from the first equation, instead of shifting x there, we can shift to y there. So it will be easy. X can be written as 4+y. So from the first equation, we can rewrite x is equal to 4+y. And then we'll substitute the value of x here. So it will be equal to 1/y minus 1/4+y is equal to 4/21. Again, cross multiplication. So it will be equal to 4+y minus y by 4y plus y square is equal to 4/21. Y and minus y will get cancelled here. So we are getting here 4/4y plus y square is equal to 4/21. Now if you want to make the calculation easy, we can cancel these two 4s there. We don't have to show the cancellation there. How we will cancel this one? This 4, if you will shift to right hand side, it will go to denominator. Then 4 and 4 we can cancel there. So we are avoiding that step. Just assume that we cancelled these 4. So remaining it will be equal to 1/4y plus y square is equal to 1/21. Now cross multiplication. So it will be equal to 4y plus y square is equal to 21. So y square plus 4y minus 21 is equal to 0. Now solve this equation. Either you can use factorization method or you can use quadratic formula method. So I think when you solved, you got the answers as 7, 3. One pair will be equal to 7, 3 or minus 7, minus 3. Negative values also we can take, because here it was not written that the numbers are natural numbers or positive numbers there. So if you are getting the negative value also you can take. Now moving on to the next question. The question is the difference of the squares of two numbers. So since two numbers are written, we write let the two numbers be x and y. Let the two numbers be x and y. Then it was written the difference of the square is 45. So we'll write x square minus y square is equal to 45. So again, difference is there. We can take x as the greater number and y as the smaller number. Now it was written, whatever the statement written, we are going to convert it into mathematical expression. The square of the smaller number. We have the smaller number y. The greater number is x and smaller number is y. So the square of the smaller number, that is y square, is meaning equal to 4 times the larger number. 4 times the larger number is x, not x square. 4 times the larger number. So we are getting y square is equal to 4x. Now instead of shifting the value of y square here, it is easy. to substitute the value of y square in this equation, first equation there. So it will be equal to x square minus 4x minus 45 is equal to 0. Now we all can solve this one. So it will be equal to, I am solving it by factorization method. If you want, you can solve it by quadratic formula. So the numbers will be equal to minus 9x plus 5x minus 45 is equal to 0. Common factor x inside the bracket x minus 9 plus here 5 is the common factor, x minus 9 is equal to 0. So we are getting the two factors as x minus 9 into x plus 5 is equal to 0. So we have the two values of x as 9 and minus 5. So here we got the two values, x is equal to 9 and minus 5. Now we'll check which value we will take there. So we wrote one condition there, y square is equal to 4x. We can check the values, we'll substitute the values of x here. If x is equal to 9, we will get y square is equal to 4 into 9, 36. So the value of y will be equal to plus or minus 6. If we will take x is equal to minus 5, we will get y square is equal to 4 into minus 5 is equal to minus 20. Square of a number, we are getting negative, which is not possible. We'll not take this value, but you have to write down all these conditions there. We are getting y square is equal to minus 20. Just write down there, which is not possible. So we'll not take the value of x as minus 5. So we'll take only one value of x, that is equal to 9. And corresponding to that value, we are getting two values for y, that is 6 or minus 6. So we'll write down the answer statement as the numbers are 9 and 6 or 9 and minus 6. Two answers will come. The numbers are 9 and 6 or 9 and minus 6. Both the values are correct. I hope the method is clear to you. So moving on to the next question. Next question number 9. You can check the question. It was written, find a natural number. So first statement, a natural number. So we'll take the natural number as x. So let the number be x. Just to check, it was written, it is a natural number. Let the number be x. Now read the statement and we are going to convert it into mathematical expression. Find a natural number whose square, square of the natural number. So it will be equal to x square, whose square diminished by 84. Diminished means decreased. And for decreased, we have the symbol minus, whose square diminished by 84. So decreased by 84 is equal to thrice of 8 more than the given number. 8 more means plus, 8 more than the given number. So again, read the statement and just check the expression. Find a natural number whose square diminished by 84 is equal to thrice of 8 more than the given number. So we wrote the expression there. So now we'll convert it into quadratic equation. X square minus 84 is equal to 3 into 8 will be equal to 24 plus 3x. Shift all the expression to left hand side. X square plus 3x will become minus 3x minus 84 minus 24. So that will be equal to minus 108 is equal to 0. Now solve the equation. Start solving the equation there. So the answer to this question is 12. You can check your answer. The answer is 12. If it is not completed, please you solve the question there and just check whether you are getting the same answer or not. Now moving on to our last question. Last question also same type there. We can check how we can write the mathematical equation there. A natural number. So write down there, let the number be x. Let the number be x. Now read the statement there. It was written a natural number when increased by 84. It is not the square. The natural number when increased means plus. Increased by 84 equals equal to sign 160 times its reciprocal. 160 times its reciprocal. Whose reciprocal? Reciprocal of the given number. So the given number is x. So its reciprocal will be equal to 1 by x. So our expression is x plus 84 is equal to 160 by x. Now what we will do? We will shift this x to left hand side. Here x is in denominator. When you will shift, it will go to numerator. X will be multiplied by both the expression. X into x is equal to x square. X into 84 will be equal to 84x. And 160 also I am shifting to left hand side. So we are getting the quadratic equation as x square plus 84x minus 160 is equal to 0. Now you all can solve the quadratic equation. Please solve the quadratic equation and you can check the answer there. Answer to this question is 8. The number we are getting is 8 there. I hope this method is clear to you. In this section, I just included the questions which are related to numbers. In your textbook, so many questions are there and all are of different type there. So from that one, I selected the questions which are based on only numbers there. So in this way, we'll differentiate the questions and then we will do there. So in this section, we discussed only the questions which are related to numbers there. Homework, it will be difficult to write down all the homework here and it will be difficult for you to also to write down all the homework from here. So homework, already I send in the WhatsApp group there. You can check the homework there and you can do all the homework. And I gave the answers also to each homework there. So you can check, and if you are not getting that answer, you are free to call me or you can send your method, whatever you wrote through WhatsApp there. If any problem is there in framing the equation, just frame the equation, and if you have any doubt, you just show to me that. So I will confirm it whether your equation is correct or not. So all, please go through the WhatsApp group there, homework, and these questions also will be there in the WhatsApp group there. Thank you.